business around the outskirts of the town. The outskirts of Aldershot became a makeshift shanty town, which in 1862 contained 25 public houses, 18 canteens, and 47 beer houses, all well provided with music, alcohol, and women to entice the men. A predominant number of women in the early were prostitutes or illegitimate army girls, and they lived their lives in poverty and squalor. Although at the time, conditions were not much better for refugees.
Show you right now. That's crazy. Greatest aviator in Britain, I don't have no airplane. Good reason for it. They just held the 1912 military air trials, and I won. Only thing is, the winning machine had to be given to the Royal Flying Corps. Still in all, I got £5,000 in prize money. £5,000. Name's Cody. Samuel Franklin Cody, born in Texas. My father was a Confederate officer in the war between the states, kind of a hero. But he was wiped out, along with the whole of my family in a Sioux raid. And I was hurt so bad, I had to crawl 9 miles on my hands and knees to reach a military hospital. Anyhow, they fixed me up, and I went and became a cowboy. I ain't that Buffalo Bill Cody, although I am related to him, kind of. And I had me a real good Wild West show of my own. Me and my wife, Layla. Well, we was famous across Europe and here in England. And then I...
Thank you.
Bless them all, but there are still NCOs who occasionally raise their voices at Aldershot, even in the atomic age. But there's been a tremendous shift of emphasis since the war ended, and Queen Victoria's troops wouldn't know what to make of the place, or the tree. Instead of dumb obedience to prescribed sets of orders, men are expected to think and act as individuals, highly agile and energetic, might be it said.
Wait,